Peki Volkan Bey'e geçelim. Lütfen Volkan Hacıoğlu. Volkan Hacıoğlu.
Buradayım ben.
Evet, o zaman sizin sunumunuzu alabilir miyiz Volkan Bey?
Tamam.
Buyurun, hoş geldiniz.
Bakın, açtık. Hoş bulduk.
Aha.
Herkese merhabalar tekrar.
Hocam çok özür dilerim. Çok
Ben
kısa
sunumumu...
bölmek istiyorum. Lütfen mikrofonlarınızı konuşmacının dışında olanlar kapatırsa çok sevinirim. Aksi takdirde ses kendisine de gidiyor. Dolayısıyla dikkati dağılabilir. Çok teşekkür ederim. Hocam kusura bakmayın tekrar. Buyurun.
Tamam. Geliyorum hemen. Tekrar geldim. Paylaşım yapıyorum şimdi. Ekran paylaşımı. Evet, şu anda ekrana gelmiş olması lazım, değil mi? Tamam, ekranımıza geldi. Evet. O zaman ben sunuma başlıyorum. Name of this... Bir ses geliyor ama arka fondan. Evet,
Gonca
o
Hanım,
Gonca
Gonca
Hanım'daydı.
Demirel, beni duyuyorsanız eğer mikrofonunuzu kapatır mısınız lütfen? Cumali Hocam, Gonca Hanım'ın mikrofonunu kapatmanız mümkün mü? Teşekkür ederim.
Evet, buyurun Volkan
Ben de... Of entrepreneur as a human agent of change, structural and contextual analysis. And I'm assistant
Sesinizde bir
professor
problem var galiba.
at İstanbul Üniversitesi Faculty of Economics. And sesim geliyor mu?
Biraz şey geliyor ama Volkan Bey.
Donuyor bazen
Evet.
sanırım ekran.
Evet.
Tamam. Bağlantı herhalde. Bu arada yoğunluk var. Burası da Cerrahpaşa bölgesi, üniversite bölgesi, hastane bölgesi herhalde.
Doğru.
Altyapı biraz yükleniyor altyapıya.
Doğru.
Okay, the introduction. Here we look at the introduction. The entrepreneur is a reflective factor of production. First we have to understand that entrepreneur is a factor of production, of course, but we have to make it clear that it has reflections on this production function. So what does this mean? It means that productive efforts of entrepreneurs are reflected on the other factors of production, which means that entrepreneur has some effects on other factors of production. And these are the importance of entrepreneurship is central for economic growth and development. And so when we think about the entrepreneur as a factor of production, in neoclassical economics especially, we see that
Volkan'da bir takım problemler var seste ama.
In growth theories, isn't the production of growth, değil mi? Ses değil mi?
Problemler var sesin gelmesinde Volkan Bey ama.
Şu anda Nur açık mikrofon ama
dediğiniz gibi donmalar oluyor herhalde Volkan Hoca. Görüntü de donuyor çünkü.
Bağlantıdan kaynaklı olabilir herhalde, değil mi? Yani devam edeyim ya da bir şekilde bu şekilde devam edelim yani.
Peki, devam edin.
Evet.
Peki.
So this is a black box approach. This is a black box approach in which the real mechanism of productive entrepreneurial activity disguised under the general term of technology. So we do not know the inside of the black box. This is something we can think of this black box as a machine, and in it production machine, of course, and in this production machine, there are some mechanisms that connects the inputs together, factors of production together, but we do not know what are the exact intricate relations between these factors. Inside of this machine, production machine, we have to look at the functions of entrepreneurship. So, sketch of entrepreneur in modern economy by different classical and neoclassical writers. So, when we look at the literature review, we see that we're all aware of the importance of entrepreneur. Cantillon, French economist, attributed a special economic function to entrepreneur. And Say, another Jean-Baptiste Say, it is a French economist again, described entrepreneur as the agent of change, and I into my presentation's heading, because it is important, agent of change. And then when we come to the classical, to neoclassical economists, we see utilitarian theory, especially Walras, conceptualized the entrepreneur as a coordinator and arbitrageur. Look at another perspective. Depicted the function of entrepreneur in firm and stated by the elements of risk and uncertainty. So Knight connects entrepreneur, functions of entrepreneur, to the risk and uncertainty. These two factors are very relevant, especially today's world in which we live, risk and uncertainty. We are living in a world that is very risky and that is very uncertain. So now entrepreneur also bears this uncertainty, which is an incalculable element, by taking risk, which is a calculable element. So what about Schumpeter? Schumpeter thought that the entrepreneur was the propulsive power of economic development. And again, when we look at the Hayek, we see that the marketplace is an environment in which learning process occurs, and here are economic agents. And Mises, again, an Austrian economist, was the market was an entrepreneurial, Mises conceptualized the market as an entrepreneurial process. 20th century concentrated on market dynamics and a concept of entrepreneur that is alert to profit opportunities. These profit opportunities come from not equilibrium point of economy, but from the disequilibrium point of economy. Tries to disturb the equilibrium situation of economy in order to find disruption and this equilibrium process, because the process, so in the three Indian. Devam edeyim, ediyorum.
Pek anlaşılmıyor Volkan Bey ama yani yapacak ses mi? Bilemiyorum.
Ses mi gelmiyor? Ses mi gelmiyor?
Yoksa... Donuklaşıyor bazen. Donuklaşıyor.
Evet, yani dediğim gibi çok herhalde yükleme var bayağı. Bu aralar herkes...
Evet.
Sabah çok rahattı. Bu saatte herkes demek ki yüklendi. Altyapı biraz herhalde. Evet, herhalde. Kaldıramıyor, şey yapamıyor.
Herhalde.
Ben zaten bir 10-15 slide hemen toparlayayım o
tamam,
zaman ben.
Tamam, toparlayın lütfen. Tamam, sağ ol. Teşekkür ederim.
Production. Third part is production function approach to entrepreneurship concepts, constraints and conversation for qualitative research method. And for the fourth part, we look at the static and dynamic functions of entrepreneurs, a human agent of risk, structural and contextual analysis, comprises of different functions of entrepreneur. For example, the entrepreneur is the person who assumes the risk associated with uncertainty, and the entrepreneur is the person who supplies financial capital. Entrepreneur is innovator. This is an important aspect for an entrepreneur. And the entrepreneur is a decision maker. And the entrepreneur is an industrial leader. Entrepreneur is a manager of superintendents. And the entrepreneur is an organizer and coordinator of economic resources. Zaten 15 dakikamız dolmuş oluyor yani. And the entrepreneur is the owner of enterprise. The entrepreneur is employer of factors of production. And the entrepreneur is a contractor again. Continue
evet,
for güzel, part.
Evet, evet, Volkan Bey. Gayet iyi gidiyorsunuz. Evet, yani.
Yes.
Ses kesiyor. Yes.
Evet. The entrepreneur is arbitrator and arbitrator. An entrepreneur is an allocator of resources among alternative uses. And the, finally, human capital approach to entrepreneurship, discourse and discussion. And the human capital approach is Schultz approach here for exogenous shocks. And the human capital is very suitable conception for entrepreneurship. And the entrepreneur ability has a market value, thereby price and quantity. So it's a scarce resource. This is contrast to the Knight and Kirshner, to steer an equilibrium model of technology adoption. And conclusion, research agenda of individual entrepreneur, entrepreneurship and economic phenomenon reaches still universally affirmed theory of entrepreneurship, as there is no real theory of classical macroeconomics. What goes name is a real a theory of the industry populated item, not a theory of the firm per se. This phrase is the key phrase for our research.
Evet.
And
peki. Teşekkür ederiz Volkan Bey.
Thank you. Teşekkür ederim ben. Teşekkür ederim.
Sağ olun.
Francisco.
Francisco da. Any questions?
O devam edecek sunum var.
Any questions? Şimdi sayın katılımcılar, Volkan Hoca'ya da teşekkür ediyoruz. Sağ olsun. Yani zor koşullarda sunumunu tamamladı. Emeklerine sağlık. Şimdi sormak iste-